Well, the NZXT Kraken immediately intrigued me about why NZXT chose this name. And does the name really have a resemblance to how a Kraken actually looks like? I mean, it might if you can push your imagination, if you have any imagination. Hey everyone, Mukul here. So recently I did a complete NZXT build video and I wanted to cover the Z63 AIO dedicatedly. Why? Because more content, that's why. Well, let me quickly share the main specifics of the AIO and not bore you with all the typical stuff. The pump which this AIO uses is by Acetec and is in their 7th generation lineup with a motor speed between 800 to 2800 RPM. The main highlight on the pump is that it has a bright 2.36-inch LCD display on it with a support of 24-bit colors on it, which can be oriented however you want. The NZXT logo is debossed on the radiator itself and doesn't hurt any of my eyes. The tubes are fine nylon mesh sleeves which do feel good and look fine, but I think they could have been of better quality. They were also quite flexible and needed almost no strength to bend them in any direction. The 280mm radiator came with two 140mm radiator P fans which are ample fast from 500 to 1800 RPM with a static pressure of up to 2.71mmH2O. They don't have any kind of LEDs or RGB in them and the fans wires were a bit sticky for some reason. But the rubber paddings on the corner are replaced by these rubber tubes which are inside the screw holes themselves. The Kraken Z63 also comes with 6 years of warranty, which is something I would personally love for obvious reasons. The Z63 and other AIOs in the same series support these Intel and AMD sockets. But if you want to mount this on a Ryzen Threadripper CPU, then you might need to order that socket separately. It came with previous gen NZXT AIOs, but for some reason NZXT decided to save some money here by not supplying it anymore. The back plates are super flexible and you can bend them every now and then, especially when you feel bored and this is the only time pass around you. The build which is going to be the test bench here is in the NZXT's H510 Elite case, running an Intel i9-11900K processor. So yeah, the full capability of the Kraken Z63 was going to be tested here. Now, because of this case's limitation, the only way to mount the radiator was on the front of the case. But if your case supports a 280mm radiator on the top, then you can go with that orientation too. So to install it on the front here, I first had to make sure that I completely unscrew the short screws from the stock fans and then replace them with the longer screws which came with the Z63 to mount them with the radiator. The AIO also came with 16 long screws exactly so that you can easily mount 4 fans on it. If you are installing in the same case, then make sure the LEDs are facing in the front so that it still pushes the air inside the case through the radiator. But I'm pretty sure most of you won't make a mistake here. And definitely don't be as lazy as me and make sure that you take out the entire bracket of the front fans and then install the radiator and the rest of the fans on it. Well, after that, obviously I'm gonna install the radiator fans as pull on the other side of the bracket, as I believe the case fans won't be enough to give adequate amount of static pressure to the radiator. But to get the fans bracket back in with the radiator sandwiched in between them, well, that required some extra work. Well, the cable bar inside the H510 Elite was totally like FU and I had to remove it and then only I was able to screw the fans bracket back in. So if I wasn't using a thermally demanding chip as the 11900K here, which can easily touch 250 watts of power with even moderate overclocking, then I might have left the cable bar there and could have avoided installing either one pair of these two pairs of fans. But I'm pretty sure no one will ever want to sacrifice the front RGB stock fans of this case, as they are one of the major elements of the overall aesthetics of this case. And because I wasn't using a chip which could have consumed, let's say, 100 to 120 watts of power, I needed all the airflow which the case and the chip could use. But if you aren't using a similar case or the same case, then you don't need to worry at all. You won't face any of these problems. But you know what really worked? Well, when I mounted these fans in such a way that their connecting wires go towards the right side of the case, the NZXT labels on the rear of these fans were in the correct orientation. Otherwise, the OCD would have definitely killed me. Okay, after all that, I finally installed the pump, which is super easy to do and needed the least amount of time throughout the whole installation process. But for the pump connectors, I can either put them on the top and make my life easier when I try to sort these cables towards the backside of the motherboard tray, or I put them down and make a living hell out of the looks of the build. So yeah, I think I'm gonna go with the former. Well, if you're also putting a LGA 1200 socket processor in your build, use the screws which have threads equal on both of the sides. And after putting the standoffs, you can put the backplate on the back of the board and screw it with these four screws. And after that, mount the pump on the top of it and then put more of these screws on top of them and tighten the hell out of them alternatively. Well, no, I was just kidding. Don't force them too much, but make sure by the end your pump has no movement. Make sure you install the Intel or AMD bracket on the pump in such a way that you have ample space to tighten the four bolts across the four corners of the pump. After that, you connect the many wires which came with the AIO. Well, figuring this on the pump side will be pretty easy. And I guess, yeah, it does look like a Kraken finally, unless you settle the mini tentacles and make their way to the back of the motherboard tray. Well, first you gotta hook the PWM radiator fans to the 4-pin connectors on your motherboard if they are available, or to a splitter or to the fan controller hub. And then connect the 3-pin pump connector either to the CPU fan or the AIO pump connector on the motherboard. And after that, connect the SATA power cable to a SATA connector and then connect the micro USB cable coming from the pump to any USB 2.0 connector on the motherboard. Well, those were definitely very many connectors. Just sort the cables and hit that power button and see the pretty screen lit on the AIO pump. Before I share the performance numbers, here's a quick look at what all this sweet screen can do. You can swap between the many presets which come installed in the NZXT Cam software, and you can also upload your own custom GIF or any GIF you can find anywhere, as a matter of fact. But I strongly feel that restricting to only GIFs is a huge shortcoming here. If only it could support MP4 or any other format which could have at least supported more colors than the puny 256 color restriction GIFs have, well, that would have looked far better than what it looks now, especially for something which typically uses more colors. But for showing the default graphs and stuff which come as default presets, the screen won't have troubles looking beautiful and vibrant. And apart from that shortcoming, the screen is ample bright, and via the NZXT Cam software, you can control and customize the curves of the pumps and the fans on the AIO. You can also change how the AIO pump or the fans should react to whether the temperature of the CPU, GPU or the liquid inside of the AIO. Well, now when we look at its performance, the i9-11900K is an absolute beast in terms of how much power it can consume and how much heat it can produce. So testing it inside a closed H510 Elite case meant the AIO was really being pushed to its limit. So I let the Cinebench R23 do a complete run for these tests, and at a sustained load of 150 watts, the average temperature stayed around 65 degrees Celsius. And at 190 watts, it stayed till 73 degrees Celsius. Well, so far so good, and at 225 watts, the average temperature throughout the run stayed till 82 degrees Celsius, and at the whooping 250 watts of power, the average temperatures reached till 88.4 degrees. To push the thermals more and check how the AIO performs inside a hot case, I ran the CPU and GPU to their full strength, and for that, I ran Fermark and Cinebench R23 together at the same time with the processor overclocked to 5 GHz all cores. And the temperatures did cross 90 degrees Celsius of the chip this time, but I need to highlight the fact that the CPU and GPU together were producing 570 watts of power alone, which means this won't be a typical task for many of the AIOs. Now, many of the consumer and desktop processors aren't supposed to consume that much of watts of power. For instance, the Ryzen 5950X consumes around 185 watts of power, max power with PBO enabled, which is kind of an auto overclocking feature for that processor. So yeah, the tests being done here are quite extreme, and I think the AIO won't have troubles performing brilliantly for many of the high-end chips even. The fans do make a noticeable noise due to their 140mm size and the fact that they prioritize cooling more than being quiet. But if you are used to the noise of a ceiling fan on top of you already, then this isn't going to bother you at all. You can also dial down the speeds of the radiator fans to 75 to 80% without sacrificing much from the performance. But if you need to save that extra 3 to 5 degrees on the chip you use, then it's better that they do ramp up to 100% at some point. The pump of the AIO was just a bit audible, but only at its full running capacity, which I think it will run at most of the times unless fiddled upon. So yeah, about the pricing, the Z63 currently costs around a whooping 23,000 rupees in India and about $244 in the US. Well, if you ask me that if the Z63 is a good performer, I would say hell yeah it is. I mean, if it can just manage to keep the overclocked 11900K below 90 degrees Celsius at 250 watts of power load. I mean, I'm not sure if there would be anyone who won't appreciate that performance from an AIO. But NZXT pretty much knows that they are selling one of the most unique AIOs out there, with of course one of the best worms on it and one of the best screens on it and one of the best software integration with them. So they clearly aren't minding monopolizing on that fact currently. They will do that because it's good for the business and no one is out there for charity, and they are gonna do business with us, of course, the consumers. Bah. Unless they find a competitor soon down the line who might just offer an equally good performance with such a brilliant bright screen on the PERM2 and is cheaper, let's assume it's cheaper. Well, till then, NZXT is not gonna bend the prices of the Kraken Z63 or for the other AIOs in the same series anytime soon. Well, so this is about it. If you like my efforts on the video, I will make sure to post affiliate links in the description below or in the comments. You can also buy from there just to appreciate my efforts on the video. That is, if you like the video. And you can also hop onto our Discord server for discussions on relevant topics. So stay safe, humans. That's all for today. MewBot out. So if this is Z63, that means X63 is multiplication of 63 or something like that.